Come on.
Praise God. Praise God. Feel a little better than I did the last time I was here. They had put me on some new medication, and I was kind of wobbly and everything. And my wife said that I hid it very well, but I really didn't feel real good that night. I feel some better tonight. Amen. Matthew chapter number 15, very famous story, very familiar scripture reading in the Word of the Lord. Many times, I'm sure you have heard this scripture preached to you. Matthew 15, verse 21. Then Jesus went thence and departed into the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, Have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with a devil. But he answered her not a word. And his disciples came and besought him, saying, Send her away, for she crieth after us. But he answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep, the house of Israel. Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. Is that familiar? Come on, is that familiar tonight? Lord, help me. But he answered and said, It is not meet to take the children's bread and to cast it to dogs.
Yes.
And she said, Truth, Lord. Yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table.
Yeah.
Yes.
Then Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman. Can I say it like I feel that he said?
Come on.
Oh, woman!
Come on.
I believe it got a hold of him.
Yes, sir. Praise God. Come on.
Yes.
Oh, woman! Great
is
thy faith. And then he said, Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. Just a few moments before he wouldn't speak to her. Wouldn't have anything to do with her. Called her dog. And now he said, Oh! Crazy things.
Yes.
Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole on that very hour. I'm going to preach to you on a very simple subject tonight. Please preach with me for a little while. Little is much if God is in it.
Come on. That's good.
That is so elementary, but it is a fact.
Come on, it's true.
Little is much if God is in it. Please be seated in the name of the Lord. Praise God. Come on, clap your hands to the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. This past week has been a very interesting week, and I won't go into detail as to what all has happened. But let me just tell you that I'm glad to be in church tonight. Praise God. And I have come here tonight to fill my cup, Lord, because I'm sure that I'm going to need the extra for this week to come. Amen. But I feel as though all that I could say to you this evening would be very, very, very futile if I didn't first tell you that you can't reach for anything new with your hands full of last year's junk. Amen. You can't shack up with the devil and expect God to pay the rent.
Amen.
My God, little God, then what are you going to do? Hang on just for a little while. Amen. I have never gotten to the place where I take any service that I am in with such a grain of salt. I consider each and every service as being extremely important to my spiritual welfare. And I know that God wants to give me some instructions tonight that will carry me down the right roads to travel. need something from the Master. Amen. This is the place that I come to for instruction, for direction, for strength, and even some endearment from the one that they will help me, carry me through, and in any type of situation that I may encounter. And I'm just going to tell you, I'll be the first to admit that I depend solely upon the Lord for His wisdom and His grace and His unlimited mercy, that I may make it through in another week or what this whole world might throw at. Amen, amen. And I might as well go ahead and tell you that I've gotten so accustomed to living in the spiritual realm of life that I really couldn't care less about the worldly things that steer so many into the carnal areas of their life. Well, it's going to get sticky for a little bit. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. A young man was preaching in my pulpit the other night. The young man that I prayed to the Holy Ghost, he said, it fixed to turn ugly. Amen, amen. Look, I'm not one of those that when I walk into the house, I have to turn the TV on if I have a TV.
Come on, come on, come on.
And I'm not one of those that keep the video stored at the arcade shops in business either. And understand this, I'm not trying to down anybody tonight. It's just that I can find many other things in this short lifespan that God has given me to fill my time with. I'll tell you what I spend most of my time doing, all right? I spend most of my time looking for every nugget of spirituality that I can possibly find, because there's coming a day and there's coming a time when I have to reach into that bag where I have those nuggets stored, and I have to pull some of them out sometime so I can find the nourishment that I need to keep on keeping on this route toward heaven. Amen, amen. Now, you may be one of those who have reached a place where you can go from service to service without needing a spiritual boost at some point in your life. But I haven't reached that place yet. Amen. I know people who can go to church and are satisfied with the formalities of just going to church, singing a couple of songs, praying out loud, giving in the offering plate, and then turn around and go home. But can I tell you that I haven't gotten to the place where that's satisfying enough for me? Well, there must be something wrong with me, because the vehicle that I'm riding in hasn't elevated itself to the place where it can go into the spiritual service station, empty, and leave on empty, and operate responsibly all week long. Amen. I'll tell you, I must be a very sad case when looked upon from the spirit world. Because I still get sick sometimes during the week. And I still get confused. And I need some guidance along during the week. And I still need the Lord to help me. Amen. And show me how to spend my finances and make them last until the next payday. And I still need the Lord's guidance in telling me how to deal with the everyday problems. Amen. And I still have people problems, and children problems, and personal problems, and head problems, and all kinds of things to have to deal with. So can I tell you that I have to get something out of every service that I get to attend? Amen, amen. Amen. This woman that was mentioned in Matthew's gospel, she must have been somewhat kindred to me. She must have been a Joshlin. Amen, amen. Mark called this woman a Syrophoenician woman, meaning that she was a Greek Gentile born in Phoenicia. Amen. Matthew said that she had come to the Lord to ask Him to have mercy on her because she was having to deal with a daughter that was devil-possessed. Amen. And the Bible lets us know that He basically ignored her. And not only did He ignore her, listen, the disciples were vexed by her presence, and they asked the Lord to get rid of her, send her away, they said. Matthew 15:24 says, but He answered and said, I am not yet, but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Now, I want us to notice something that is very important tonight. I want us to notice how and why everything suddenly made a change. Verse number 25 says, then she came, she worshiped him, saying, Lord, help me. Can I tell you tonight, that is the biggest step that anyone can take when they need some assistance from the Lord. Amen. Worship. Worship will get God's attention when nothing else will. When you see Jesus had a mission, and it was to save the lost sheep of the house of Israel, and he was trying to shake it off. Amen. And explain it away again by saying, it is not meet to take the children's bread and cast it to dogs and cry to the priest. And what I'm about to tell you, probably the number one greatest response that this woman could have given the Lord. She said, you're absolutely right.
Truth, man. Truth.
Read your Bible. Truth, Lord. You are dead on it. Absolutely right. She said, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table. My God.
As
sitting around the table. When a crumb falls off that big enough to see, they'll all three of those dogs will dart out after it at the same time.
Amen.
Are you getting my drift?
Come on.
As a matter of fact, according to how hungry the dogs are, they might even get violent with each other over the crumbs that fall.
Come on.
Yeah.
Anybody getting my drift?
Yeah.
Come on. Amen. 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 Matthew chapter 11 verse 12 says that from the days of John the Baptist unto now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence and the violent take it by force. You know what? Sometimes we might have to get violent in order to receive what we need.
Right.
I truly hope you are getting what I'm talking about tonight. Amen. Sometimes we just have to make ourselves get out in the alley and lay that hand. Amen. The women that have hallelujah. You are those struggle across the first hand, God. Sometimes we have to get out of the alley. Amen. If the devil has his way, amen, you'll be sitting down all night long and you won't get anything. But I'm going to tell you, I think I see some people here in this house tonight who have come. Amen. The Bible says little as much. Amen. Amen. Little as much. My title is little as much if God is in it. Amen.
Yeah.
I'm telling all of us tonight, amen, it's not the size of the crumb. Amen. It's your aggressiveness. Amen. To get enough of those crumbs to be some good. Praise God. Praise God. I'm just going to tell you that I don't intend to let a service go by without going home with something. Grown man, grown woman, medium age child, amen, all the way down to the little guys. Amen. I'm telling you, everybody needs something from God. And the best way to get it is watch the table and see the crumbs that fall off. Amen. That woman said, yeah, Lord, you're right. Amen. I'm sorry. I'm a dog. Amen. I have no reason to be here whatsoever. Truth, Lord, she said. Amen. But she said, Lord, I'm going to tell you, every time you drop a crumb off that table, amen, I'm going to bump my head if I have to.
Yeah.
To it. Amen. I'm going to skin my leg if I have to lay that table. Amen. I'm going to get it done. I'm going to get that crumb, amen. Because I come out of something. Lord, I'm not going to leave here without you saying nothing. Amen. And that's what I'm preaching about tonight.
Come on.
I'm not going to leave this place without having received. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We've got a bunch of little guys around our church. Amen. And when they start the hand signing, we've got some little tots that are up there. We're teaching them to take the place of those who were getting a little older. Amen. And at some point, the little ones will grow up and they'll become teenagers or whatever. And they'll be taking the place of those who are getting older. Amen. And so, we'll be up there, man, the Spirit will be doing it. Amen. My granddaughter is one of them. Amen. Michaela Gossett. Amen. Her and Bree. And let me tell you something about her and Bree, all right? Them are the loudest two in church. I'll tell you, them kids can bust my eardrums and leave these hearing aids on.
Yeah.
Amen, amen. When them two get started, I'm like Rick Morris is setting, you know. Amen. And so the Spirit gets to moving. People get to dancing and shouting while they're having sign worship. Amen. And my granddaughter will run over me. And when she starts over me, Bree will see her. And Bree will head right over that way too. And she'll pull down my coattail and she'll say, How old is Michaela? She's not 4 yet, is she? Yeah. Amen. She's 3 years old. She'll be 4 in April. Amen. And now watch this. She'll run over. She'll pull my coattail. And she'll say, people, can I run?
Yeah.
Come on.
And I look at her and I'll say, why do you want to run? Here's her response most of the time. Yeah. Amen. Can I tell you? It don't matter whether you know why or not.
Come on.
You don't have Amen, amen. Hallelujah. And I tell our church all the time, don't you try to stop these kids from running because I tell them to run.
Right.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. I'm teaching them to take our place. Look, I'm not just going to tell you I'm 66 years old, proud of every day of it.
Amen.
Amen. But one of these days, I'm going to have to ease off. I'm going to have to ease off the field. Amen. I'm just telling you. It's coming, church, and I know it as well as anybody. Amen. And that's why I had prepared myself to meet that day. Amen. Here, about 3 weeks ago, before we went to the mountains, amen, a couple weeks before we went to the mountains, I got what is called vertigo.
Yeah.
Anybody ever had it? Yeah. Amen. Let me tell you what happened with vertigo, all right? I'm standing still, and you're moving.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Amen. And I'm getting up in the morning time and I tell my wife, I don't know. I looked at her and I said, I wonder if this is what you feel like when you fix the cross over the chilly tide. Amen. She said, oh, hush up. You're not going anywhere. I said, thank you. Amen. Amen. So I kept battling that, my doctor goes to my church and I said, boy, what am I going to do about this? And she told me, come on up and to check me out and all this kind of stuff. And I was crazy with it. Amen. But I promised those grandchildren that I was going to take them to the mountains. Amen. And let me tell you this, all right, and then I'll move on along, all right? When I decided that I was going to take these 5 grandchildren up there, myself and my wife, amen, I decided it was going to cost me more than usual. Amen. And so, Bill Callis, you just have to wait till next time, all right? He's going to put on my case, and then we'll go out and call him to come to the unit and take him up there, amen. And I think I told him something like, Matthew needs you here. that was the quickest thing I could think of to say, amen. And so I told my banker, I said, look, man, let me tell you something. I went down there to borrow money. I said, let me explain something to you. I'll take these 5 kids up there, and we're just going to have a good time in the mountains. Look, if I call you from up there and tell you to put some money in my account, I need you to put some money in my account.
Yeah.
He raised up out of that seat, looked me square in the face, and he said, how many grandkids you say you was taking? I said, there'll be 5 of them up there. He said, I'll wait for you to call.
Yeah.
Amen. 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 But I had promised him that I was going to take them up there. And I started praying, God, listen, these babies won't understand. They wouldn't understand. Amen. People promised them all year long to take them to the mountains on their school break. Amen. And now he's going back on the promise that he made. And I started to God, what am I going to do? I can't even stand hardly. Amen. Believe it or not, the vertigo I drove all over the road, but I drove.
Yeah.
Amen. And so I was praying. I said, God, help me with this. Amen. Lord, it's not that I just necessarily want to blow all that money up there, but I promised these babies are not going to understand. And these are your children, Lord. We gave these babies to you. They're yours.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
Now, I'm going to tell you, you may not talk to God like that, but I do. Amen. Sometimes I get desperate with it.
Come on.
Amen. Sometimes I get violent with it.
Yeah.
Amen. And I go away from him. Oh, I don't hear you talking to me.
Come on.
Amen. And I'm reaching for him. And I'm trying to get his attention, sis. Amen. But it seems like everything that I do is not working. Amen. Hallelujah. But then I have to get violent about it. Amen. And I start crying out to God and pleading with God like that Syrophoenician woman said, Lord, yes, I'm no good. I'm as sorry as they come. Oh, God, but I'm hungry and I need some help. Make a long story short, we got back from the mountain about a week ago. Amen. Had a great time. When I walked in the door, amen, started wobbling around like that. I thought, oh God, here it comes again. Here it comes again. And I said, Lord, I'm in jail. Amen, I'm in jail. So I started crying out to him, listen, I'm just going to tell you, this now I lay me down to sleep, prayer days are over.
Come on.
You need to listen to what I'm telling you tonight. Amen. Amen. Those short, simple prayers. Amen. That really have no meaning with them. Amen. I'm going to tell you what the church needs to do. All right? The church needs to confess.
Come on. That's right.
Come on. Amen. We act like we've been living for God for 40 years, and that sin stinks so bad, oh, it wouldn't even come near me because I'm so righteous. Don't start lying to me. Amen. Sometimes we need to get down before God on our knees and say, God, I'm a sorry son that really is. Amen. Amen. God, I've been a sinner all my life. I've done things, Lord, that I am not proud of. Amen. But God, I'm calling on you. Amen. Because I have been baptized in your name. Amen. And your words are casting all our care on you. For you care for us.
Amen.
And I begin to quote the word over and over and over and over and over. And that provoked me to preach what I preached this morning at my home church. Amen. I preached on the only thing, amen, that was more powerful than the name of Jesus. Amen. If I give you a scripture, can you put it on the screen? Psalm 138, verse number 2. The only thing that is more powerful. Look, we pray in Jesus' name. We baptize in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on. We dedicate our children in Jesus' name. Every move we make is in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. But there's something that is more power. Amen. Have more power and more powerful. Amen. That God magnifies above the name of Jesus. Does anybody know what it is? I'm going to tell you what it is, all right? Amen. Psalm 138, verse 2. Amen. It said, thou hast magnified thy word of the law, thy name.
Yeah.
Look at it. I will worship the Lord thy holy temple and praise thy name for thy loving kindness and for thy truth. For thou hast magnified thy word above all thy name. Let me tell you something, Lord, and you learn this quick, all right? You take the word of God, amen, and you get it in your heart. You get it way down inside of your gut. And when you start meeting the miracle of God, start putting the word of God. And because the word of God is more powerful, amen, than the name. Hallelujah. And I preach on the magnified word of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Look, how many times?
Oh God, here I go.
Can I get in trouble here tonight? I stay in trouble in Boone. Amen. Sometimes I think they want to just vote me out. Amen. But they get the thing sharp on me. Nobody else help me. So they're at the end of the week. Amen. We walk up to people and we say, "Wow, in Jesus' name."
Come on.
And nothing happened.
Right.
Hello?
Hello?
Boy, it's mighty quiet in here now.
All right, Mom.
That's the gospel. I have laid my hands on many people and said, "In Jesus' name." And they walked out there with the same sickness that they had when they came in. Amen. But never have I ever quoted, amen, verbatim the scripture, the word of God, that is more powerful than the name, added with the name. Amen. Never have I ever done that without somebody receiving something that they haven't even.
Come on.
Amen. The magnified word of God. God's word is magnified above all thy name. Amen, amen. I'm preaching tonight, amen, that little is much if God is in it. It don't take a whole lot, amen. Listen, my sister one time, she was in this Bible thing, amen, Bible questions or Bible verses, amen. And I forgot what they called it, but all the kids started on the back, and every time they quote a verse, they would move up one pew, and the first one that was on the front pew won the game, amen. And so my sister, even Jean, amen. My other sister was pretty well versed in the word. And Jean just didn't do a whole lot of study back then. Amen. And man, they spoke in scriptures coming and going. Scriptures like, rejoice evermore.
Yeah.
Jesus wept. Hello. God is love. The easy scriptures. Amen. And then they run out of the easy scriptures and someone had to come up with some others. Amen. And they started coming up with scriptures. Amen. And it came Jean's turn. And she looked around.